Dr. Maroon, I know you've been studying some really amazing nutrients, nutraceuticals. We talked about CBD, and tell me about the science of this. This is an interesting phenomena that's come about in science and been ignored a little bit.
Well, I think another neurosurgeon who is somewhat of an iconoclast and willing to take on the institutions and the present individuals in medicine is Sanjay Gupta. And Sanjay Gupta actually made a CNN special entitled Weed that has garnered an immense amount of interest in medical marijuana. Mm-hmm. And I think people think of medical marijuana as marijuana being a therapeutic drug. And what is the medical aspect of marijuana is primarily a component called CBD, cannabidiol. So in the sativa plant,
The male plant,
exactly. One arm is marijuana, which is very high in THC.
Which is what gets you high.
Which is the high part of it, which is why most kids and many adults use it. And then the other is hemp.
Yes.
From hemp is derived cannabidiol, CBD. CBD works on different receptors than marijuana in the brain. And CBD indeed has various medical therapeutic benefits that have been now widely publicized in the medical literature. It has essentially no psychotropic effect.
Doesn't get you high.
Doesn't get you high, and yet there are medical benefits. What are the medical benefits? Analgesia. It's an analgesic. Mm-hmm. It relieves pain.
Pain.
It's a powerful anti-inflammatory. It may have effect on dividing cells.
Cancer.
It's been used in cancer. Mm-hmm. In fact, there's a study now going on in Great Britain with a drug company called GW Pharmaceuticals, in which they're using this in addition to other drugs for glioblastoma multiforme, which is a very highly malignant brain tumor. So it has a lot of potential therapeutic effects that I think we're going to be seeing it used more and more it's a nutraceutical now. Mm-hmm. It is legal. Mm-hmm. As long as the THC content is less than 0.03.
Yes.
And there are companies now that are manufacturing this from hemp that are purified, that don't have any significant THC, that is being looked at in various studies in terms of the analgesic, anti-inflammatory, anti-cancer effects that we're talking about. So
yes,
it's a very new area. Mm-hmm. Well, actually it's not. It's been used for 5,000 years.
Yes.
When you really think about it.
Right, as a therapeutic intervention.
As a therapeutic intervention. But now we're looking at the science, the molecular biochemistry, how it works at various receptors in the brain, in the immune system, and in the body. So it's an exciting area that needs more investigation, more clinical as well as basic science work.
My cousin had developed breast cancer, and she underwent chemotherapy and radiation treatment, and yet a period of time after the cancer reappeared, and she called me crying in April and said, what do I do? And I instructed her to change to a plant-based diet. Her husband is a chef, so I sent her my book, Simply Healthy, which is gluten-free, dairy-free, plant-based, oil and oil-free, that is. And he called me up and said, well, I can't do this oil-free. And I said, yes, you can. Just follow the recipes. I know you're a gourmet chef. You're a good chef. You can do this. And they called back, said, yeah, okay, we're trying the recipes. They'd call me and text me from the grocery stores and things. And over time, I also encouraged her to look into CBD. And she got a preparation that was appropriate and looked through the literature with me about the dosages. And less than a month ago, which a period of 9 months, she had dropped 45 pounds of body fat. The cancer tumor was gone. And the only thing left was remnants from where they had done the surgery and the radiation. There was a little activity, but it hadn't progressed. And the doctors looked at this case, the oncologist, and said, this is amazing. And she was then asked to take other drugs to prevent a reoccurrence. And so she's in that dilemma, that point of, but then the drug she was asked to take, if you ate anything with grapefruit, would change the P451, I believe, pathway and could, as one of the risk factors say, cause death. And I said, well, hold on a moment. If you're taking a drug to prolong your life, but the risk is death if you make a mistake in what you eat, and you're eating a whole plant-based diet, let's think about that for a moment. You've got this far, and you're not ignoring monitoring. The doctors are monitoring you. You know, we're doing proper imaging and evaluations. So that's a new choice, but we all have a choice at certain points, and I just wanted that story told because not many people are brave enough to decide to not choose chemo or radiation and go a pathway. Now, some people do it conjunctively together, and I wouldn't discourage that, but I'm also concerned about the toxins that are involved with chemotherapy, and does it not only target the cancer cell, but there's what's called cancer stem cells, so they can regrow, the overall tumor will shrink, and everyone will applaud, we've cured this cancer with chemo and radiation, but what if it comes back? And it will, because it metastasizes and can show up in other organs. So I'm looking at this battle of the body and the immune system and the mind and lifestyle, and I'm truly wanting people and doctors to start really seriously considering for their own lives and for their children and their future children, now with Fukushima and the radiation particles and the toxins and the risk of cancer in the Western diet, what should we do to do a clinical study of lifestyle medicine intervention and those who decide, I don't want to do chemo or radiation, but I want a proven study, and that has yet to be done.
You're absolutely right. I'm obviously, it's an incredible result that you're talking about. The average normal oncologist is going to say, well, it's gone because we gave her chemotherapy, or we gave her radiation therapy
years ago.
And that's it. And as you so well stated it, we need clinical studies.
Yes.
Anecdotal reports.
Yeah.
We need clinical studies that will prove or disprove the effectiveness of some of these unorthodox treatments. And that's where we are, I think, with various agents. I've spoken at this meeting, actually, in the past about a ketogenic diet for the treatment of various types of malignancies, and in particular, brain tumors. And we're actually instituting an IRB at our institution to look at ketogenic diets in the management of various types of malignant brain tumors. But these are all studies that need to be done. I think we're making progress, but it's interminably slow at this point.
Yeah, my cousin was also successful, I believe, because there was a product that we provided her that had turmeric at a significant dose, astragalus, it had asparagus, it had apricot. Some people banned apricot, saying, oh my gosh, this is, you know, Laetrol, what is this? And we gave her DIM, dimethylmethane, with a delivery system and indole-3 carbonyl, like eating 2 pounds of raw cruciferous vegetables a day. But the point is that we wanted to look at what supplements supported the body's immune system, because you can't ever talk about curing cancer to anyone, and it's not fair to say that until these studies are done. But you can talk about what do we do to build up the immune system in everyone, because we may develop cancer at several times in our life, some people believe even daily, but hopefully the immune system's strong enough under the right conditions through lifestyle medicine appropriate factors, right?
Well, Nick, it's been a great pleasure sharing these thoughts with you. I mean, we're both talking about a lifetime of experiences and accumulated knowledge.
Yes.
And I just hope that your audience can take away a few pearls from our discussion. So thank you very, very much.
Thank you, Dr. Joseph Maroon.
Thank you, sir.
And Isabella Maroon.
Thank you.
Good luck, and I'd love to sponsor you. I want to see a winner out there, at least complete the race, right? That's where it's out. It's all about completion and being in the now, right?
Thank you.
And hopefully we'll have our subscribers go ahead, and if you haven't yet subscribed to the YouTube channel that we offer with our program, and to continue to follow Dr. Joseph Maroon's career, and Isabel Maroon and what she plans to do in her life. I'm sure this is just the first time on the set. So thank you very much, everyone. and have a wonderful life.